For jeg må helt ærlig innrømme å si at jeg, okay, jeg tror jo på den lukeparkeringen. Jeg tror enda mer på den nå hvis jeg faktisk pusher ut denne her kiden og ser at bilen faktisk stopper.
Du har helt sikkert hørt om Bosch tidligere og har kanskje et Bosch-produkt hjemme. Men visste du at de er så mye mer enn bare elektroverktøy og hvitevarer? De er som et høyteknologisk powerhouse som i forkant av temaer som AI, smart mobilitet, helsetjenester og mye mer. Deres teknologier kan rett og slett bli funnet overalt. Tenk på din absolutt favorittbil. Yes, Bosch har mest sannsynlig teknologien i din bil. Det derfor vi her på Bosch Innovation Campus i Budapest. I denne serien skal jeg møte ingeniører som jobber hos Bosch, og jeg lurer rett og slett på hvordan det å jobbe her, hva de driver med og hvem de faktisk Så let's go! Nå jeg i Bosch sitt Innovation Garage, og jeg skal lære meg å lukeparkere. Jeg har ikke fortalt noen her i Bosch at jeg ikke har lappen, men heldigvis så det kun ett tassetrykk man kan gjøre for å lukeparkere. Nå skal jeg møte Daniel, som skal fortelle meg om alt dette her.
Hey Daniel.
Yes.
Hello.
Hi Joachim, yeah. I'm Daniel.
Daniel en bilentusiast, der lidenskapen hans for kjøretøy startet allerede i barndommen, der han spøkte med at han kjente til alle bilmerkene før han faktisk kunne prate. På Bosch jobber han som ingeniør med fokus på parkeringssystemintegrasjon og kjøretøytest. Daniel ser muligheten for parkeringsteknologi som utvikler seg sammen med selvkjørende biler. En avgjørende del av dette for å sikre sømløs integrasjon av autonom kjøring til autonom parkering.
What are you up for today?
We're working on some development cars in terms of parking systems. Mm-hmm. Have you heard about autonomous parking before? Have you tried it?
I have never tried it. Can I admit something? I don't have a driver license.
Okay, then it's going to be interesting experience
yes.
then.
Yeah, it will. But I've heard about it. For me, I think it sounds like something that's in a futuristic movie. Can you show me a little bit of
Definitely.
How it works?
You will see it for yourself. Yeah. This is a bit different to any commercial cars.
Which yeah, I see that.
You see there are a couple of screens and so on, which, let's say, visualizing all of our data, what we usually record with these cars.
How does this visualize? I don't get what are the screens showing.
Okay, basically the map that the car is creating mm-hmm. from the inputs of the sensors, what we get from the ultrasonics and the cameras, it shows on the map what's basically surrounding the vehicle.
Okay.
And based on those map, the vehicle is capable to make decisions.
This might be a stupid question, but is it like this program you guys are using, or is some kind of AI technology, or yeah?
There's also AI involved,
okay.
definitely in data processing and so on. Mm. So all the visualizations and the algorithms, basically, they are trying to make sense of the pictures what we are recording.
Yeah.
You can see Smart also feed. Some GPS antennas on the top, but where the real magic happens yeah. is at the trunk. So you can see that most of the wow. wires.
And seriously, this looks like a car from Back to the Future.
Yeah, exactly. But not for the same purpose.
So okay.
Time traveling. So there are some industrial computers there, also yeah. some components that are communicating and so on. So definitely this is the part where we process all of our data.
Wow.
And we are speaking about 1 or 2 gigabytes per second. So imagine a regular mobile phone just being full in 2 minutes.
Yeah.
So that's the amount of data what we are recording.
Yeah, what's the purpose of everything?
Yeah. These are processing all the data that's coming from the sensors, what you can see at the bumpers, okay. for example. Here you can see the ultrasonic sensors,
yeah.
which you can imagine similarly to bats, basically, that yeah. are possessing ultrasounds, and those are reflecting from the surrounding objects, and then you can measure the distance from them.
Okay.
As well as it has 4 cameras, 2 yeah. on each side, and 1 at the front and 1 at the back. Mm. And those data, what are coming visually and also mm-hmm. from the reflections, are being fused to build that sort of map.
Jeg må jo bare si at jeg skjønner typ nesten ingenting. I have to say this in Norwegian.
Yeah, sure, go ahead.
For me, I try to understand it all, but for me, it could be just you pranking me. Mm-hmm. So can we like put it to the test?
Yeah,
and try
of course.
If it actually works.
Yeah, trust yeah. me, it really does something.
Yeah.
So it has a purpose.
Okay, cool.
Let's go for it. As you can see, this is just a regular commercial yeah. vehicle. It's already on the streets. You can buy it whenever you want it.
How many times have you done this?
Well, that's a good question.
Thousands times?
Several tens, thousands of times.
Really?
I guess the team is over, yeah. I don't know, 100,000 hours already.
Yeah.
So what we're going to see now is that we're going to drive past the potential parking slots, which with just a press of a button, the car is going to measure the available parking slot. Mm-hmm. If they are large enough to fit in.
So now it measures on both sides.
On both sides. All of those. Exactly. Mm-hmm. And you will see on the screen that there's a free parking slot.
Yeah.
All I'm going to do is to choose
press
that one.
That one, okay.
That I want to go reverse.
Yeah.
And all you need to do is to put it into reverse and let go of everything and let the car do the rest.
Oh, Jesus, cool.
And you'll see on the screen what's going to happen.
It's not going to crash, no?
No, trust me. It's as safe.
Han gjør ingenting. Det her jo sykt.
And
it parked perfectly, right?
And we're done.
Yeah.
That's all.
Wow. Can I go outside and check out how it looks from the outside?
Sure, yeah. Why not?
Cute. Okay, gøy. Nå skal jeg se hvordan han lukeparkerer fra utsiden. Men jeg så en ting her. Kan jeg teste ut denne her og pushe ut denne kiden og se om bilen faktisk stopper? For jeg må helt ærlig innrømme og si at jeg tror jo på den lukeparkeringen, men jeg tror enda mer på det nå hvis jeg faktisk pusher ut denne her kiden og ser at bilen faktisk stopper. For hvis den bilen kjører over en stakkars liten unge, det ikke greit. Så Daniel, can you try to park one more time? Yeah. Uff, tenk hvis denne ungen blir påkjørt. Det har vært forferdelig. Jeg regner med at den ikke gjør det. Did you stop the car?
No, I didn't.
No?
It stopped by itself.
It did it by itself?
Behind.
I saw this one here. I was trying to test it out.
Yeah, definitely. It works.
And you did nothing, right?
No, I haven't touched anything.
And we have the GoPros in the car so I can see if you're lying or not.
Definitely. No, no tricks, no magic.
It has a very good sensor, right?
Definitely.
Yeah.
It can sense the child as well and non-vulnerable objects as well. So like boxes, poles, anything like that.
Cool. First, I have to say thank you so much for not running over my kid. But I'm just so curious about all this technology that you have been showing me. How do you think the future would look like?
Well, I can show you that.
You can show me?
Just a glimpse. At first, this might seem a regular car, but you can see some extraordinary details. For instance, on the rooftop.
On the rooftop, yeah. What is that?
There are some LiDARs there, rotating lasers. Yeah. We are collecting data as well.
Yeah.
It's based on laser technology. And you can see the same type of sensors just as I showed you before. Cameras
as well.
That's an ultrasonic sensor as well. And you can see some radars as well at the corners of the bumpers. So that goes all back to the computers we have. Wow. And this is to develop the future of parking.
In like 20, 30 years, what do you think parking and technology with cars would look like?
Definitely autonomously driving cars in the future.
Wow. So when I'm 30 years old, so when I'm hopefully when I'm 90 years old, do you think I could just fall asleep in my cab?
By far, I'm so.
Yeah,
I'm
wow. Sure. My cab, I mean my car, but you understand what
your
I mean.
Car,
I don't need a driver. Yeah,
no,
maybe?
Not at all.
Wow.
You may not even need a driving license in the future.
But you really believe that's the future?
Absolutely.
Yeah.
It's on the way, for sure.
Oh my God.
We're getting closer day by day.
Herregud. Det sykt å tenke på. Tenk at jeg en del av fremtidens teknologi nå med biler. Akkurat her nå. I mean, I have to say thank you so much for showing me
my
all
pleasure.
This. Herregud, det her var så spennende. Fy fader. Og for en smart fyr. Så nei, virkelig, å tenke at jeg kan bli 90 år, og bare ligge og sove i bilen uten at det en eneste sjåfør som sitter i den. Herregud, fremtiden blir spennende. Hvis du likte denne videoen, så må du sjekke ut de to andre episodene vi har laget, som ligger på Bosch sin YouTube-kanal og på deres nettsider. Jeg utfordrer deg til å tenke neste gang du bruker smarttelefonen eller sitter i en bil, og tenke over hva slags Bosch-teknologi som i den. Så er det bare for meg å si på gjensyn, så ses vi i neste video.